Hello viewers, in this short video, we will discuss about wired and wireless networks and how are they different from each other. So let's start. Wired network. In the networking world, wired, as the name suggests, refers to any physical medium connected through wires and cables. The wires or cables can be copper wire, twisted pair, or even fiber optic. Wired connectivity is responsible for providing high security with high bandwidth provision for each user. In fact, wired connectivity is considered highly reliable and incurs very low delay, unlike wireless connectivity. Wireless network. Wireless, as the term refers, uses air as a medium to send electromagnetic waves and infrared waves. Wireless devices have antennas for communication. Wireless connectivity provides a major benefit of user mobility and ease of deployment. It also becomes more useful in areas where wires can't be reached. Now that we have high-level understanding of wired and wireless network, let's start with their differences. First is the communication medium. A wired network includes copper or fiber as its communication medium. Copper can be Cat5, Cat5e, Cat6, or even Cat7, while fiber can be single mode or multimode fiber. On the other hand, communication medium for wireless network is air with frequency range of 300 MHz to 3 GHz. In terms of standards of communication, wired network follows the IEEE 802.3 standard, while wireless uses 802.11 standard. Talking of mobility and roaming, we see limited mobility and flexibility with wired communication. As an example, a Cat5 can only support data up to 100 meters and drops after that. On the other hand, wireless communication has much more mobility and supports much longer distance. Next in the list is security. Wired networks provide higher security, and generally, physical intervention would be required to breach the security of wired setup. On the contrary, wireless setup is prone to attack and can be compromised easily if additional security overhead is not introduced. Wired can support speed up to 1 Gbps and in fact 10 Gbps in some cases. However, wireless doesn't provide so high speed for end devices. In the subject of access to network, the former requires physical access. In contrast, the latter requires proximity access, that is, you just need to stay near the wireless network and get connected to it. Wired system provides lesser delay compared to wireless. At the same time, wired provides higher level of reliability than wireless framework. With reference to change flexibility, it is difficult in wired networks as compared to wireless network. Further, speaking of working principle of both technologies, first one uses concept of CSMA/CD, which operates by detecting the occurrence of a collision. The second uses the concept of CSMA/CA, hence reduces possibility of collision by avoiding collision from happening. Due to its nature, wired technology experiences very less interference and fluctuations as opposed to wireless, which has high vulnerability to this. Since wired networks involve cables, hence installing a wired network is pretty much cumbersome and intensive on manpower as opposed to wireless networks, which are easy and less labor intensive. Same is the case with installation time, which is much higher for wired networks, like setting up cables, laying them, labeling, and then physically connecting devices in the right sequence. wired networks are physically separate setup. They are dedicated connections, while on the flip side, wireless networks are shared across multiple entities. Cost is an important factor while deciding which technology to use. In this arena also, wired network cost is much higher, hence not as pocket friendly as wireless networks. As stated earlier, maintenance cost in addition to installation cost for wired setup is on higher side. Wired systems use devices like router, switch, bridge and hub, whereas wireless routers, access points and wireless controller are equipments used in wireless network. Finally, let's enumerate the benefits of each technology. Wired setups provide greater speed, higher noise immunity, are reliable in addition to providing greater security. Some of the benefits of wireless networks are that we don't need to care about hassles of cables and laying or patching them. It is best suited for mobile devices, which are generally in roaming or mobile. And lastly, it's easy to install and manage the wireless infrastructure. Hope you liked the video and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.